Hello friends, today I will discuss the ZPF method. This method is used to calculate the voltage regulation of the alternator. To apply this ZPF method, we need data of open circuit characteristic and short circuit characteristics and the zero power factor full load characteristics like this. So here, when we draw the graph between field current and the open circuit voltage, then we get the characteristic like this. This is called open circuit characteristic. Then draw a tangent line parallel to the initial portion of the OCC curve like this. This is called air gap line. Then, from the short circuit test, we get the rated armature current and corresponding field current. So, let that field current corresponding to the rated armature current under short circuit is given by OB dash like this. Then, from zero power factor full load characteristic test, let us say the armature current and the field current is this. That point is B. So this point indicates the terminal voltage is rated and the armature current is rated and the corresponding field current is this. So now, draw a parallel line from point B to the x-axis such that that line is equal to the OB dash. That here is it is equal to KB. Then, from K, draw a parallel line to the air gap line such that it will cut the OCC at point C like this. From point C, draw a parallel line to the y-axis such that it will cut the line KB at point A. Now, the triangle ABC is called the Peutier triangle, and the AB length will indicate the field current corresponding to the armature reaction. And the length AC represents the voltage drop across the leakage reactance. That is like this, IAXAL. Now let us assume the load current is IA and its power factor angle is phi and it is lagging with respect to the terminal voltage. Then we write the generated EMF per phase in terms of load current and power factor like this. V cos phi plus IA RA whole square plus V sin phi plus IA XAL whole square. This IAXAL already known from the graph, that is this. And the other values, so we know from the OC and SC tests, so substitute them, then we get E1 value like this. Once we know the E1 value, then go to the graph, identify the E1 position on the y-axis like this. From there, draw a horizontal line like this, that is parallel to the x-axis so that it will cut the OCC at this point. From there, draw a parallel line to the y-axis so that it will cut the x-axis at this point. That is this point. So the field current corresponding to this we call as I suffix R. Then, having known this IR and IAR, we can calculate the resultant of these two field currents such that it will become IF like this. So, once we know the resultant of IAR and IR, identify the point on x-axis, that is field current axis, like this, that is M. From there, draw a parallel line to the y-axis so that it will cut the open circuit characteristic at this point. From this, draw a parallel line to the x-axis so that it will cut the y-axis at point E2. And this E2 is the per phase induced voltage in the alternator. Knowing this E2, so we can calculate the voltage regulation of the alternator like this. E2 minus V divided by V into 100. The experimental setup for getting the OCC and SC test is like this.